After 2 years of sporadic lockdowns, we're now discovering that many Aussies have developed a serious addiction to grass. No, you damn hippies, not that type. That type, forced to spend so much time contained within our properties, many of us developed an obsession with green grass, either apartment dwellers obsessing over the lawns they didn't have, or those lucky enough to have yards hoping to upgrade them so they look as nice as Glen Gibbo's. Glenn is passionate for lawn maintenance and says many people are green with envy.
No, I wouldn't say that.
Oh, okay.
I've always been a massive sports fan, seeing how they mow the ovals and patterns and all the football fields really ignited a passion, I could say, trying to make my lawn like that.
Glenn co-runs Australian Lawn Fanatics, a Facebook group with 85,000 sodding members who share tips and questions on how to get their lawn green. I'm sorry, I don't really get that reference.
During the COVID epidemic, we noticed a lot of people were stuck in their homes and that made them want to go out and mow and put the earphones in, give themselves a bit of zen time on the lawn. It's really gone gangbusters from there.
Many people are now taking the lawn into their own hands, working hard to get them as perfectly cropped as possible, sharing photos and stories of things going wrong, like this avid gardener we spoke to, who offered this tip to visitors.
Get off my lawn.
I would say the top ways to give yourself an Instagrammable lawn, use quality products, follow a plan, use soil wetters and mow as often as you can. I mow probably every 2 or 3 days.
The lawn has always been the symbol of the great Australian dream, and it seems the pandemic may have reminded us just how much we value it. So, are we ready to turf our indoor lives in favour of, well, turf? Or is this love of the lawn just a fleeting fancy?
I had some friends so ahead of this craze. Shouts to Anton and Greg, who every year at Christmas we would go over to their house and they would have a photo of their lawn that they'd worked on all year.
Yeah.
Anonymously. Separate lawns, anonymously listed, and you had to vote who was the best.
What, like it was on the hall stand as you came in?
Guy
like put
and
a token
and his
in
son-in-law
each.
Battling it out every year to see who would have the best.
Could
lawn.
You abstain?
Well, no, it would be an insult.
Oh, wow.
An absolute insult.
Compulsory
voting. A slap to the face of all their hard lawn work.
You know, Christmas dinner can be a bit fraught when it comes to a family gathering. Yes. Surely there were some arguments that spilt out later.
And there was a lot of questions over, you know, was there bribery and all that kind of stuff. But, yeah, this went on for years. So
who won more, the old dog or the young
pup? Well, I would have to look into the archives for that.
He's abstaining!
I've done it again, oh, gosh.